Hello, my name is Danny Gibson and I'm an AmeriCorps member at the First People's Buffalo Jump. Today we are going to be doing a simple plant press to dry and preserve plants. This activity is great for spring and fall season when colors are changing and plants are at a dynamic point in their life cycles. Plant pressing is a common practice within the scientific community to help identify species and take notes on a habitat. But your pressings can also make a fun keepsake, art project, or journal activity that sparks creativity with a hands-on approach. If you stop by First People's Buffalo Jump State Park for a Junior Ranger activity kit, you'll receive a herbarium that has a journal prompt and it'll help you stay organized. For this activity, you will need a few simple items that you can typically find around your house. You will need two pieces of cardboard for the top and bottom of your homemade press, paper — I typically use newspaper or printer paper — some rubber bands, ideally two wide ones, but three or four skinny ones would be just fine as well. And lastly, something very heavy or flat to put on your press while you're drying out your plants. Books are a great option, but a heavy piece of wood, a flat rock, or something along these lines would work just fine. Before we get started, let's keep in mind how to ethically harvest. We always want to be respectful to the environment, and with a few easy guidelines, we can ensure that we are doing our part to keep the environment healthy. We should be taking enough for a sample size, but we don't want to overpick. Always leave the only or last flower or plant. This ensures that we are not drastically removing a population of a type of plant from an area, and we are promoting biodiversity. If you're in a neighborhood, be respectful of other people's gardens, as they probably would like their flowers left alone. And if you're unsure and there's no one that you can ask, the best practice is to just find somewhere else to pick. If possible, use a field guide while collecting plants to help you identify what you're collecting. Field guides are a great resource, and you can typically find one in your local area online or at your local library. Be sure you're leaving the area the same or better than you found it. Don't litter, and always try to reduce the spread of weeds by cleaning your shoes before and after a hike. Now the fun part, you get to go out and find plants. Here are a few tips for success to have the best experience during your activity. Smaller or flatter plants tend to press better. However, if you find a larger plant that you really want to collect, consider dissecting the plant to highlight the different amazing parts. If it's a flower, consider only taking a few petals rather than the whole thing. Fresh plants work best for pressing. If you're traveling somewhere for your collection, you could bring a plastic bag with a lightly damp paper towel to keep it fresher for longer while you travel to and from your location. While you're exploring, keep these questions in mind. Why was this plant successful in their environment? What drew you to the plant that made you want to preserve it? Was there a lot of this plant where you found it, or only a few? Can you guess why? Now that we have collected our plants, it's time to put them in the plant press. This typically does not take very long, especially if your two pieces of cardboard are already prepared beforehand. We want to take our paper and fold it in half. If you are using a newspaper, you may need to cut it into a more manageable size. We are going to put one piece of our cardboard down and put our folded piece of paper on top. Make sure the folded paper is open and put your plants on the paper and fold your paper backwards over the plant. Once you have your plant inside your paper, put the second piece of cardboard on top and secure the cardboard press together with two rubber bands. Now you have a plant press. The last thing you need is to put a heavy object on the top of your press. Depending on the size and shape of your plant, smaller plants could range from 3 days to 2 weeks to finish. Large plants could take longer. It's okay to occasionally check it, but try to limit it to once a day or less. Here's an example that I made a couple days ago. Thank you for watching First People's Buffalo Jump's Junior Ranger video. Please feel free to reach out if you have any questions about this project, and feel free to share your finished plant pressings or your herbarium on our social media pages. We would love to see how creative you were and all the interesting plants you found. Next week, we will be doing our How Fire Works Junior Ranger program with Ranger Alice, and we hope you all tune in.